Light Rail Manila Corporation officially started the construction of the Cavite Extension Project last May. LRMC is a joint venture company of Metro Pacific Investments Corporation, Ayala Corporation, and the Philippine Investment Alliance for Infrastructure. With us now for more from our Rockwell studio in Makati is Juan Ping Alfonso, the President and CEO of Light Rail Manila Corporation, or LRMC. Good to have you with us, Ping. Welcome to the program.
Good morning, Kathy, and good morning to everyone.
So what is the status now of the construction of the Cavite Extension Project? I mean, it's been more than 2 months since you started construction.
Yes, we started with the boreholes for the different locations. And in the next few weeks along the Parañaque area especially, it's going to be exciting. The people are going to see the construction of the columns, putting together the viaducts for the stations, for the railway. We're gonna go from the Sukat section towards Baclaran and first of all do the viaduct constructions, and then after that do the electromechanical and train completion. So we're quite excited because you're gonna see a lot of the work on the streets very soon, in a few weeks.
So it's gonna look exciting because people are gonna see what's going on, but how are you funding the construction because the government hasn't approved the fare hike that you petitioned for?
Right, the funding for the Cavite Extension has already been established. We have a consortium of banks that have given us the funding for the Cavite Extension, so that's in place. So it's really independent from any fare hike discussion right now.
But have you heard back? Because Transport Secretary Artugada did say last May that the Light Rail Transit Authority Board is still reviewing your petition for fare adjustments.
Yes, the Light Rail Transit Authority and the DOTR go through a process for the fare hike petitions. And we respect this process. I think the next, there are another two steps that we have to go through, including a public consultation and publication. And then after that, we'll work with the DOTR on the next steps.
But it's costing you a bit of a fare deficit. I mean, you've incurred about $100 million since December because of the delay in the granting of that fare hike petition. How much has that grown since last December for the three quarters of 2018?
Well, for the fare hike deficit, it's I think the numbers that you're quoting are accurate, about $100 million a quarter in terms of fare deficit. So every quarter we incur about $100 million in the fare deficit claims.
So that's gone up, say about $200 million, is it? I mean, what's the total amount now, the total fare deficit incurred now since you took over LRT1 operations in 2015?
Yes, it's already, the number is up to about $1.2 billion, because for the four quarters since 2016, the first full year of operations was 2016. So you multiply that by each quarter and up to 2019. So it's about that number.
It's about $1 billion. I mean, that's a lot of money. And you're still constructing the project. I mean, isn't that hobbling the scheduled construction of the project?
No, actually, the funds that are set aside for the Cavite construction have already been set aside. And that's a separate funding situation. In terms of recovering these fare deficit claims, we're constantly coordinating with DOTR and with the Office of the Railways of USEC Bataan. So we're trying to work with them in terms of recovery of the fare deficit.
And you're mentioning two more steps before you get to a resolution. What sort of timeline are we looking at?
We're hopeful that by the end of the year, we'll get some at least clarity on these two events. It's still early stages in terms of us talking with them on what the next steps should be, or time-wise what they look like.
All right. What about the right-of-way issues? Are there still outstanding issues in some areas keeping the project from moving right along?
The right-of-way issues have a lot of the problems that were there, we now have solutions. So it's basically a question of implementing the solutions. Sometimes there are areas where we have to deal with utilities of several companies, and it's putting these people on the table and really choreographing the events and the work so that things can be implemented and the right of way can be given free and clear. We've cooperated with LRTA on this and the DOTR. They've been extremely helpful, as well as the government agencies. And I think that's why we're in a position to execute today, you know, because of the whole team effort of the DOTR, the LRTA, and the LRMC.
So we can therefore say it's 100% resolved, the right-of-way issues.
Yes, it's resolved. But at the same time, our approach is also just in time. No? So we're building from one section to the other, and the schedule will allow us to execute.
Now, what about the new train sets? When do they arrive from Spain?
The new train sets are coming in about a year's time. These are built by CAF from Spain, with propulsion systems from Mitsubishi, you know. So those train sets, there are about 30 train sets that will be delivered not all at once, no, staggered delivery.
It's pretty exciting to see new trains. Yeah, but what are the chances then of more frequent glitches? Because my understanding is the old train sets comprise almost half the train sets of LRT.
Yeah, when the new train sets are delivered, we'll be able to retire a lot of these old train sets. The old train sets, we've actually increased the capacity from these old train sets from about 77 vehicles to about 114 today. We've spent some money rehabilitating them. At the same time, we keep them safe. That's really our mission, no? To give people a safe journey every day. And we're not saying that there are no problems. There have been issues, but no more than 10 minutes at a time. And we always make sure the passengers are safe and alight at the nearest station to be picked up by the next train. So, the journey is still pretty safe and seamless now.
Final point, Bing, pain points aside, I see that you've developed a mobile app for the LRT1 passengers. I mean, how significant is this, and how soon before it goes online?
Well, thank you for mentioning the app, Kathy. We're launching the app. We're doing a soft launch in August in Apple iStore and also in Google Android. And what it does is that it helps passengers really navigate through the LRT system. It gives them real-time schedules on when the trains are arriving. All of the 30 trains on the LRT system will have GPS systems beaming this to the app to the customers. And also there's going to be a crowd function, so similar to a lot of the traffic functions. So if one customer or one of our riders is beside two stations, he can choose the station with the least amount of traffic. No? And later on also, I think connected to LRMC's vision of really, you know, transportation mobility, integrated mobility, will help the passenger ride from, you know, from his first mile to the last mile, no? So up to the last ride that he needs going to his office, no? We feel this is significant, and we can aggregate a lot of the different functions, maybe including the ride after the LRT or the ride before the LRT.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'll look it up on my app store. Thank you so much for joining us, Juan Ping Alfonso of LRMC in Makati.